Hey, Serana. Serana. Come here. Come here. Stand over here. This way. Come on. Come on. Okay, okay, that's good enough. Wait right there.
Bruce, Rhoda!
Hey, Jim. 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 Jim.
What?
It's your turn to go and watch tonight.
But I just found out I need the dragon scroll.
Yeah, and you should have been sleeping because now you get to stay up another 4 hours.
I can stay up as long as I need to.
Well, you better, because this is Tesla's base, and he doesn't like it when someone dozes off.
Blade, I'll be fine. You act like you don't trust me or something.
It's not that I don't trust you, it's just that you haven't proven to be a very reliable sentry.
Oh, really? Give me 3 examples of when I wasn't reliable.
Let's see, there was when you left our hiding place to ask the elite where the bathroom was, there was a time that you sold all of our turrets to a traveling salesman, and let's not forget when you blew up the entire top of our base.
Yeah, well, wait, how many was that?
That was 3, Jim.
Well, you're a person.
All right now, have fun.
Stupid Spartans. Never respect me. Ever since boot camp. Oh, this is so boring. I wish I could bring my Xbox out here. That way I could play Skyrim and keep watch. What would I do without video games? Then again, my mom always told me that you could entertain yourself with your imagination. I haven't tried that in a while. Maybe I'll imagine myself in Skyrim. This isn't Skyrim. Dang it! Let's see, try again. What? This makes no sense. Okay. Well, kind of imagined myself in the future. Okay, go back, go back, go back. I can't do it!
Maybe you're not concentrating hard enough.
Who's there?
Don't you recognize my voice?
Oh, Mom, is that you?
No, you idiot. I'm you.
What?
I'm your imagination.
I don't get it.
Think of me as an imaginary friend.
Okay. What do you want?
I don't want anything. You're the one who imagined something that you want.
Well, I want people to respect me as a Spartan and not as just this nuisance that's useless and can't do anything right.
Go on.
Ever since I was a kid, I've just been a disappointment. I always thought that joining the military and the Spartan program was the right thing for me, and I knew that I could get my life turned around and do something right. I dreamed that I could be something great. I dreamed that...
I dreamed a dream in times gone by, when hope was high and life worth living. I dreamed my squad would never die. I dreamed that God would be forgiving.
Then I was young,
and unafraid. And dreams were made and used and wasted. There was no ransom to be paid. No song unsung, no wine untasted. But the flood, they came at night, with their voices soft as thunder, as they tear your base apart. They turn your rank to shame. I slept the night watch on my side. I missed the attack and missed the plunder. They took my squad away in a stride. And they were gone when morning came. And still I dream they'll forgive me for my mistake caused us a tether. But there are dreams that cannot be. And there are storms we cannot weather. Oh, I had a dream my life would be so different from this life I'm living, so different now than what it has killed the dream I dreamed.
Man, no wonder you're so messed up.
Well, what do you mean?
Well, not everyone goes through something that traumatic.
Yeah, but my failures didn't even stop there.
Continue then. Just get it all out.
There, out in the darkness.
Hey, what happened to the music?
Let's try not making this one a musical ripoff.
Okay, fine. So, guys, you still haven't told me what my job is here at this new base. I mean, it's obviously not gonna be anything like a sentry, or okay.
You think this is funny, son?
No.
Well, it ain't! You wanna know what your duties are at the base?
I guess so.
What you do is every morning you get up.
Okay.
And you see, and then you go out with the other guys and you do what you do. And then at lunch, you eat. And then at dinner, you eat. And then you go to sleep, see?
Mama, I'm hungry.
Go, darn it! Honey Boo Boo, get back inside!
That sounds great, ma'am. So when will we, be doing our training during that, schedule?
You ain't training! That's why you're here! You're obviously too unfit for the Spartan program. And since it's too expensive to decommission your armor, it's easier to just keep it here. You see?
What do you mean by you guys?
Hi! What's your name?
Well, my name is Corporal Private James Jennifer Johnson.
Well, gee, that's so cool. It's good because my black is again, boys.
Sorry, I didn't catch that.
Shut up, stupid.
Okay, wait, what?
Hi, my name's Ladnar.
Your name's Ladnar. Well, is it nice to meet you, Ladnar. So, where are you from?
I don't know. The only thing I know is my name, and I don't even know if that's right, so I just kind of say YOLO to Susan Whitterman.
Why couldn't I just have a coffee that night to stay awake?
Hey, guess what time it is?
5:30?
Yep, it's dance time!
Hey, excuse me! Excuse me! I really do think there's been some sort of mistake.
What?
I said, I think there's been some sort of mistake. I don't belong here. I really shouldn't be at a base like this. I know that I have more skills than a lot of these.
Well, I told you you're here for a reason. Can't wait. Now get back out there and dance.
Okay. Hey, Ladnar. Ladnar.
What?
Come with me. I have to talk to you about something.
Okay.
Okay, Ladnar. You need to be honest with me. Do you actually like it here? Just don't answer that. Don't you want to be in a place where you're not pulled down from your mistakes or from your lack of skills? Don't you want to just go out there and fight the war that everyone else is fighting?
Maybe.
Okay, that's good enough, because we're breaking out of here.
Okay, because I know the way out.
Oh, you do? Well, then take me there.
Excuse me.
What is it this time, Ladnar?
My friend Ginger has to go to the bathroom, and I'm showing him where it is.
Oh, all right.
Well, you're pretty smart, Ladnar. I wish I would have thought of that.
Thanks.
Okay, now how do we get out of here?
Follow me.
So you're telling me that the warthogs aren't locked up, the keys are in the ignition, and there's no lock at the front gate.
Yep, that's right.
Why such low security?
It's because no one ever wants to leave.
What do you mean?
Look at us, Jim. You might be the exception, but we all are kind of useless here. I mean, I don't even know how to hold a pun correctly.
You mean a gun?
Exactly.
Come on, Ladnar, give it a shot. I mean, you can't...
No, Jim, you're not talking me out of this. I'm going with you, and that's final.
Come on, Ladnar. Wait, you... Whatever, are you ready to go?
Actually, I went in the activity center, so I'm good.
Okay, wait, no, I mean leave.
Well, we only have pine trees up here, so there aren't any leaves.
No, not leaves. We are departing from this base.
You're not making any sense.
You guys aren't supposed to be here.
Ladnar, hurry, get in the warthog.
Well, you could have told me that before, stupid.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Yeah, let's go.
You kidding me? Hey!
Huh? What?
Do you guys even know how to drive a warthog?
No.
So, that happened.
Yeah, I guess we should have, thought through the fact that we were never trained on warthogs.
Oh, Jim, I have another idea!
So, let me get this straight. If we jump off the cliff and kill ourselves, we'll awake from the dream that we're obviously trapped inside and wake up in reality.
You sons of sarsaparilla are the stupidest Spartans I've ever had to deal with.
Okay, Ladnar, I'm choosing what we do this time.
Yes, I believe that would be the most rational choice.
Oh my god, Ladnar, what happened to your voice?
Well, you see, my friend, it's all coming back to me. About 5 years ago, I drove off a cliff and hit my head, thus causing the brain damage that turned me into the Ladnar you know and love. After jumping off of that hill just now, I hit my head again, and it must have shaken my brainstem back where it's supposed to be. For my name is General Frederick Ladarnus.
Yeah. Frederick seems like kind of an ass.
You struck me for no apparent reason. Being the gentleman I am, I'm going to shake it off. I'm going to go walk by the pond, and you can do what you want.
Fine, I will. You can just stay here then. I'm going to use the comms and see if I can tap in an SOS, get lifted out of here. Let's see. Set range to... We'll go ahead and say galaxy-wide. You want to make sure everyone hears me. Attention to all UNSC fleets. This is Private First Class Jim. I am stranded on a base that I don't, belong on. I
was put here in Captain?
So,
Lieutenant, you should probably listen to this.
Captain,
what is it?
It appears to be some kind of distress call. I'll put it on the loudspeaker.
Okay, and kick it off.
Attention to all UNSC.
My God. Lieutenant, do you hear that?
Yeah, where the hell is it coming from?
Shit, it's coming from Reach.
Where is it going?
Everywhere.
What?
It's going everywhere. The Covenant, they'll know. They'll know where Reach is.
Frederick, do you hear that?
Yes, it seems we're under attack.
Attack? From who? The rebels?
No, you fool. From the Covenant.
No, Jim's imagination. It's not funny. It's not supposed to be funny. This isn't comedy. This is the biggest mistake in the history of the universe. A mistake I'll have to live with for the rest of my life. The blood of billions of innocent lives is on my hands. And no matter how long I contemplate and think that there's some iota of possibility that it was not my fault, I always come up short. That's why I'm a failure. Not because I talk like a hippie from the 1970s, or because I think rocks are alive. I'm obsessed with coffee, and think elites know where the bathrooms are. That's all I'll ever be. Don't you see? I'm just one big, colossal waste of an Arcadian life form.
Oh my God, Jim. I don't believe it.
Oh, yeah. I was born in Arcadia. It has really nice summers, but the winters are
to take 23 out of the 50 months of the year.
Yeah, I bet. But I bet skiing is amazing that time. Well, I mean, Jim! Reach! You caused the invasion of Reach.
Yeah! No!
Okay, Jim, seriously, stop crying. You're a freaking Spartan. And can we stop this stupid dramatic music? Thank you.
You probably hate me more than you already do, don't you?
Well, Jim, I've never hated you. Yeah, you're kind of slow and the biggest pain in my ass since I first deployed, but you're part of my squad, and it's going to stay like that until your parole ends, which, now that kind of makes sense when they put you with me and said, don't let this guy out of your sight. But anyways, it's not your fault, technically, because the Covenant have been zeroing in on Reach for years, and maybe your transmission was the last one to get to them before they attacked, but it is definitely not your fault. Not entirely, at least.
Oh, phew. All right, that takes the load off my chest blade. Now I can move on in life with my head held high, and I can just take these things in my past and just let it go. Oh, I just want to sing another song about it.
Wait, Jim, no. We're already pushing usage rights as far as I can go. Don't. Oh,
let it go. Let it go. I'll rise like the break of dawn. Let it go. Let it go. The depressed gin is gone.
I give up.
And here I stand in the light of day.
With it, yeah.
Took almost 2 years. Or is it over 2 years? I don't really want to guess, but that took a long time to finally get out. But now it makes me want to do the last episode for the season, episode 11. That's gonna be like this episode, but three times as hard because I'm going to have a bunch of other voice actors. As you can see, I basically voiced this one all by myself, which makes production easier, but it's not as fun because, you know, you can tell that every single voice in there is me, basically. So yeah, hope you enjoyed that. Make sure to like if you liked it, share if you were excited to finally see this next episode up there. Tell your friends and subscribe. I know we're a pathetic little channel, but I kind of want to get bigger with videos like this and other live action stuff as well. So, yeah, have a good day and